Welcome back in part 2 of negative sentences, friends. In part 2, we will solve practice sheets of negative sentences. But before we go ahead, a small request to all of you to please like the video, share with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. Friends, in this exercise, we will convert present indefinite and past indefinite tense into negative. Friends, let us see first of all that how to identify present and past indefinite. Friends, we use present indefinite tense where the action happens at the regular interval, and we frame the sentence by this formula. Either we use first form of verb or we add S or ES with the first form of verb. Like we have added in this sentence, she eats food. Whereas in past indefinite tense, which is used when the action ended in past, we use a second form of verb, that is ate. So in this way we can recognize these two tenses. If S or ES is added or nothing is added, then it is present indefinite tense, and if the second form of verb is used, then it is past indefinite tense. Friends, I expect that before beginning with negative sentences, you have gone through all the parts of tenses. So the helping verb of indefinite tenses do and does, and did is a helping verb of past indefinite tense. Friends, here we shall revise one more thing, that we put S or ES wherever the subject is third person singular. So let us see once again the grammatical person chart, which we have already done in all the tense parts and in negative sentence part 1 also. But if you are new to this video, then let us revise once again. We had discussed earlier that first person is always I and second person is always you. And if we do not talk about first and second person, then everything, every person, every object comes in third person category. If it is third person singular, it means if it is one, then we use those verbs which are ending with S. This is the association which we have made so that you can learn them. If you talk about action verbs, like if I say eat, out of eat and eats, then also we will choose those verbs which are ending with S. For example, if she is a subject which comes in the category of third person singular, then she does, she is, she was, she has, and she eats. Every verb is ending with S. Friends, remember this association. So now we can begin our exercises. So they pay their bills. The main verb is pay here. And we know that helping verb of present tense is do and does, and past tense is did. So friends, we had discussed in part 1 also, helping verb is needed if you have to write a negative sentence using not. Only in be verbs you don't need helping verbs, but in other cases you need the helping verb to use not. Like they pay their bills. It is a main verb here. There is no helping verb. So we will need the helping verb to make it negative. Now in present tense, if we need the helping verb, we will take the help of do and does. In grammatical person chart, I had discussed that if the subject is not third person singular, then we can use those verbs which are not ending with S. If they are third person singular subjects, then we use those verbs which are ending with S. This is not third person singular. I can show you once again. They is coming in the category of third person plural. It means with this, those verbs will come which are not ending with S. Like do, are, were, have. Therefore, with they we have chosen do. So they do not pay their bills. What we have done is we have applied a helping verb, which is do. We have added not, and then we have added the main verb, which was pay only. So helping verb plus not is a formula to make any sentence negative. It takes long to reach. The first step is to recognize the tense. Ending with S, it means present indefinite tense. Now look at the subject. Subject is it, which is third person singular. So with third person singular subjects, we will choose does. So it does not take long to reach. Helping verb plus not and main verb, which is as it is we are putting. I heard a noise, second form of verb, it means this is past indefinite tense. Friends, this is a complete tense chart where you can see that how the sentences can be recognized. So in past indefinite tense, we use a second form of verb. And friends, you can also see that except these two tenses, past indefinite and present indefinite, in other tenses, helping verbs are given. They are underlined in all the 10 tenses we can see. So there are only 12 tenses, and out of 12, only in 2 helping verbs are not given. In rest of the tenses, helping verb is always given. So according to the structure, you can put not after helping verb in every sentence. She will not eat food. She is not eating food. She was not eating food. She will not be eating food. She has not eaten food. She had not eaten food. She will not have eaten food. She has not been eaten food. She had not been eating food. And she will not have been eating food. In all the tenses, you can put not just after the helping verb. But friends, children get confused in making the negative sentence in these two tenses, present indefinite and past indefinite, because helping verb is not given. This is a main verb. She eats food. She ate food. This ate and eat is a main verb. In part 1, we had discussed that when any verb is left alone in the sentence, it becomes a main verb. So friends, in these two sentences, we need to take the help of helping verbs. So the present helping verb is do and does, and past indefinite helping verb is did. So I heard a noise. It is past indefinite tense. For making it negative, we will take the help of did. I did not hear a noise. Now why hear has come in place of heard? Because did is already a second form. So two second forms cannot come together in one sentence. It's a formula. It's a rule. We have to remember that two second forms cannot come together in the same way as two S or ES cannot come together in one sentence. Like in the second sentence, it does not take long to reach. We have not written it does not takes long to reach, because S has come at one place, so with another verb it will not come. In the same way, two second forms cannot come together. When you are using did, you have to use the first form of verb, that is here. I like to read signs, present indefinite tense, because this is not the second form. So it is a first form, therefore it is present indefinite. According to the subject, we will take the help of do, because with I, do comes. I do not like to read signs. Or we can write, I don't like to read signs. These words which are written in this way are known as contractions. Contractions means short form. So you can use contractions also. We only avoid contractions in formal writings. At other places, we can use contractions. He went to store last week. Went is a second form of verb. Therefore, it is past indefinite tense. So we will take the help of did. He did then not go to store last week. Went is a second form. We will use the first form, that is go, because with did already second form is given. So he did not go to store last week. Helping verb plus not plus main verb. I drank full glass of juice. The main verb is drank, which is the second form of drink. So past indefinite tense. Now we will take the help of did as a helping verb. So I did, then we will put not. First form is drink, full glass of. My sister runs a website. Runs is a main verb. It is ending with S. It means it is present indefinite tense. So for that, we take the help of does. Why does? Because my sister is third person singular subject. We have to remember that out of does and out of do, we have to choose these two verbs according to the subject. If subject is third person singular, then only we use does. With other subjects, we use do. And we have learnt the association also, that with third person singular subjects, we use all those verbs which are ending with S. And does is also ending with S. Therefore, in this sentence also, my sister runs a website has come. S has come at the end. So while making it negative, we will write like this: my sister does not run a website. We will remove s here. We visited our grandparents. Visited, the second form of visit, it means past indefinite tense. So did will be used. We did not visit our grandparents. My brother speaks Chinese. My brother does not speak Chinese. We eat our food together. So we do not eat our food together. Let's move to the next exercise, friends. In this exercise, we have to convert the sentences in which be verbs are given and modal verbs are given. So let's see in part 1 what we had studied about be verbs and modal verbs. Friends, we had learned that if a sentence contains be verb, that is, RM, was, were, then we only put not after it. We don't need to use any helping verb in this, like she is ill these days, she is not ill these days, Ananya was at home, Ananya was not at home. In the same way, if any sentence contains modal verbs, then also we can put not after it. Because modal verbs are always accompanied by the main verb, therefore we can put not after them. You must help him, you must not help him. You should wait there, you should not wait there. So just after the helping verb, which is modal verb, we are putting not. But in be verbs, helping verbs are not required. So this is the easiest one to do. We just have to pick out the be verb, which is out of is, RM, was, were, and the modal verbs we will pick, and we will only put not after them. John is at home right now. John is not at home right now. We are adding not after the be verb. We are cleaning the window. We are not cleaning the window. We were ready for exams. We were not ready for exams. They must listen to us. This is modal verb. They must not listen to us. I am in trouble. I am not in trouble. You should talk to him. Modal verb. You should not talk to him. Pihu might go to school. Might is a modal verb. Pihu might not go to school. Father will bring the ticket. Father will not bring the ticket. This is also modal verb. We could fly high. We could not fly high. Modal verb. You can sing a song. You cannot sing a song. And in this exercise, we will convert the sentences which contains has, have and had, which belongs to have family. We have discussed about it in detail in part 1. We need to revise that if these verbs are helping as main verb, then rules will be different. And if these verbs are working as auxiliary verb, then the rules will be different. So let's revise their position first. I have explained this in part 1, but we will have a short revision here. That friends, has, have, had and do, these verbs can act as a main verb also and auxiliary verb also. If they are alone in the sentence, then they are main. But if they are accompanied by another main verb, then they work as an auxiliary verb. You can watch part 1 first if you want to understand that in detail. These verbs are alone in the sentence here. He has a pen. There is only one verb which is alone and which is has. Therefore, this will be main verb. But if the same verb comes with the another main verb, then this becomes helping verb. So in second sentence, has is helping verb. In the first sentence, has is a main verb. In the same way, have is main verb in the first sentence because it is alone in the sentence. But in second sentence, it is used with bought. Bought is an action verb and which is a main verb. So here have is working as a helping verb. So friends, when we will convert it into negative sentence, our formula says that not comes with the helping verb. Now in the second sentence, it is good enough because we have one helping verb here, which is has. We are talking about this sentence. We have a helping verb has here. Therefore, we can put not after it. Because as per the formula, we have to use helping verb plus not if we want to make any sentence in negative. So he has not broken a pen. This is correct now. We will see all the second sentences first. We have bought a car. Already a helping verb is there, so we can put not after it. We have not bought a car. They had not eaten their lunch. We do not attend the meeting. But friends, we have to take the help of helping verb in the first sentences because helping verbs are not given. And we have already learned that do and does are the helping verb of present tense and did is the helping verb of past tense. So now we have to take the help of these helping verbs. He has a pen. No helping verb. So we have to arrange helping verb. So we will take the help of does. Because he is third person singular, so we will take the help of does. He does not have a pen. We will write have here. Whether it is has or have or had, we use not have only. So he does not have a pen. Now look at the second sentence. We have a car. So there is no helping verb. So take the help of do. So we do not have a car. They had their lunch. They did not have their lunch because we have to take the help of did, which is a helping verb of past tense. Do is a main verb here. There is no helping verb. So take the help of do because with we, do comes. We do not do our duty. So in this way, if the verb is working as a main verb, then the rules will be different. And if it is working as auxiliary verb, then it is simple that just put not after it. Now we have to find out whether has, have and had is working as main verb or auxiliary verb. In both the conditions, rules will be different. My mother has a purse. Only one verb is given. It means it is working as main verb. So we will take the help of does here because my mother is third person singular. So my mother does not have a purse. I have a new bike. Single verb. So working as main verb. If it is main, then we need to arrange helping verbs. So with I do comes, I do not have a new bike. Baby has taken bath. Two verbs are there, friends. Has and taken. Taken is a main verb here. So has will not be the main verb. Rather, it will be auxiliary verb or helping verb here. So we have already a helping verb. So we will not take the help of these now. Now we will directly put not here. It means baby has not taken bath. He has been working hard. He has not been working hard. Anu had chopped the vegetables. I have cut my hair. You had the chair. So you did not have the chair. Ansh had finished the lunch. So simply put not. Siu had a nice house. So take the help of did. Siu did not have a nice house. She had emptied the box. We have taken the example of had only so that you can compare in 9th and 10th sentence that here had is working as main verb but here had is working as auxiliary verb. We will just put not after it. Let's solve the last exercise. In this exercise, we will be solving the sentences which contains do, does or did and it comes in the family of do. We had discussed that do, have and be are the three helping verbs and do is ahead of do, does and did, have is ahead of has, have had and be is ahead of is, are and was, were. So now we are converting the sentences in which do, does and did come. Friends, here also we will see that does is the main verb here. It is alone in the sentence. It is working as a main verb. So we will take the help of does. According to Shalini, we will take the help of does. Shalini does not do her work. Friends, it is very interesting exercise because the main verb is also do, does and did in these sentences and the helping verbs are also do, does and did. There was no main verb, so we took the help of does. It means this first does is the helping verb, this is not and here do is the main verb. This is the formula, this is the sequence. They do their work, main verb. No helping verb given, take the help of do. They do not do their work. She did her work, no helping verb is given, so take the help of did. She did not do her work. The only thing we have to take care that when you are using second form at one place, their first form will come. Two second forms cannot come together. Hira does the same thing. So Hira does not do the same thing. Two S or ES cannot come together, so we have removed S or ES from here. She did wrong with her. She did not do wrong with her. Did will become do here because it is already a second form and two second forms cannot come together. Madhur does the job, so Madhur does not do the job. I hope now concept is clear and on the same pattern we can do rest of the sentences. If you have any confusion, you can re-watch this video and when you watch this video again, then things will become more clear. We do the work together. We do not do the work together. We did our duty. We did not do our duty. Now these two sentences are the examples of imperative sentences and in imperative sentences we use don't before them. Stand straight, don't stand straight. Clean your cupboard, don't clean your cupboard. We had discussed in part 1 that we use don't in imperative sentences and these sentences are very easy to be formed. Friends, here this video is getting ended. If you have any doubt related to this topic or any other topic, you can leave your comments in the comment section and I'll surely reply to all of them. Thanks for watching. Stay connected.